by Luke Alexander, who's the CEO of Newcore Gold. Luke, it's lovely to meet you. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Tell us a little bit about the company. Now, you've got the Enchi project in Ghana, big gold yep. producing country. Tell us about Enchi.
Yeah, I mean, so first, I guess Ghana is Africa's largest gold producer, sixth largest gold producer globally, just after the U.S. Newcore Gold, we're a TSX-listed company. We trade on the OTC as well. It's a district-scale exploration project that's fundamentally underpinned by a very robust PEA that we put out in 2021. We're in the process of updating that PEA. We'll have that out in the first half of this year. It is going to incorporate a larger overall resource, so we're expecting a larger project to come out of this updated PEA. So district scale, exploration, advancing the project towards a construction decision that's trading at a level that I think is very attractive for investors today.
Excellent. And in terms of, as we, you know, we've touched on Ghana being the sixth largest gold producer, a lot of great projects, a lot of great deposits. How does Enchi kind of stack up next to, you know, there's some big names in the Bibiani gold belt as well.
Yeah, so 200 million ounces of gold have historically been discovered in Ghana. It's called the Gold Coast for a reason. You've got three of the top 10 largest gold producers on the planet with significant operations there. Newmont, obviously being the biggest gold producer globally. They've actually got a project called the Ahafo Project, which sits to the north of us. They're investing another $1 billion into that project. So a number of 5 million ounce plus deposits that sit along trend from us. We were very fortunate to amass such a large land package when we did. We've been aggressively exploring that. We've drilled 95,000 meters over the last 3 years. We've put out a couple of resource updates, and all of that will feed into an updated PEA, as I mentioned, that we're putting out in the first half of this year. So it's a great country to be operating in, and we're very fortunate to have such a large land package there.
Yeah, absolutely. Look, I know you can't really give us any specifics of the PEA. When it does come out in the first half of 2024, but you know, given that gold is really seems to be performing well of late, I mean, how confident are you that, you know, a sustained gold price will really play into this project's economics?
Yeah, so from a PEA perspective, I can reference you to our 2021 PEA that we put out, and we've got a lot of detail on our website that kind of outlines the economics of that project. But at a very simple number, at a very simple level, three numbers are key. $100 million of CapEx for 100,000 ounces of production for an after-tax NPV of $300 million at an $1,850 gold price. So those were the numbers that we had in our 2021 PEA. So obviously a very economic, robust project. Our 2024 PEA, which again we'll have out in the first half of this year, it's going to incorporate a larger overall resource, as well as we've de-risked a number of the ounces. So we've moved 740,000 ounces into the indicated category, an additional 970 in the inferred, so it's going to include a larger overall resource. We've also done a lot of met test work, social environmental baseline studies, hydrological geotech work. So all of these aspects of de-risking the project will also be incorporated in the PEA that we put out in the next few months here. So we're really excited to get that out to the market, and we see it as a big catalyst for the company.
Okay. Well, Eric, thank you so much again, Luke. I appreciate you taking the time.
Yep, you're welcome.
Okay. And for Proactive, I'm Angela Harmantas.